We have two gentlemen joining us right now that are very important to the city of Buffalo and to this program.
The Butcher
We
coming.
Are joined by our senior Bills correspondent,
Mafia.
Benny the Butcher, and Bills offensive tackle, Deion Dawkins. Gentlemen, thank you so much for taking the time to join us.
What's up, man? Good morning, Pete. What's up with y'all? You see it?
So, Deion, I'm going to start with you. You guys have made some key signings this offseason. Backup quarterback Mitchell Trubisky and also Emmanuel Sanders. You had a great season last season. What are your expectations coming into this season?
Yeah, well, if you look at what they're doing, like, but they're just getting guys around Josh. And our team is built around our quarterback, as everyone knows. And they're just putting guys in position to help this guy succeed and do what Josh does. And it's simply that, you know, it's not checkers, it's chess.
Deion, welcome to the show. And I feel like this movie Paid in Full, one of my favorite. Benny, he need a medallion around that neck. He need a medallion around that neck. A big Griselda medallion around that neck.
Nah, talk to him.
Definitely, definitely. Don't. He just chilling right now. Don't let him fool you. He got pieces over there.
No doubt. So I know that you've seen the Patriots loaded up this offseason, big fella, and particularly defensively. They re-signed Cam Newton also. What are you anticipating for your division foe in New England?
Well, as you know, right, it's never easy. Every year is extremely hard, and our focus isn't on the Patriots. It never is. Like, not to say it, but Tom Brady was the Patriots' whole life. Tom Brady isn't there. So we have a whole different Patriots team that we have to deal with, and I focus on Josh. I focus on my O-line. And it's just us. As long as we handle us, we got it. The Patriots ain't nothing for us to think about until that time comes up on the schedule. But it's Buffalo Bills era, man. It really is. It's Josh Allen. It's Stephon Diggs. It's Cole Beasley. Shoot. It's Deion Dawkins. It's OG Bobby Johnson. Sean McDermott.
Brian Dable,
Buffalo. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's Bills, man. Bills Mafia. We ain't worried about that. Brandon Bean. Big Baller Bean.
Deion, I couldn't help but notice that you're wearing a sweatshirt with your quarterback on it with three eyes. Explain to me what that represents to you.
Man, talk to me. Look, man, and as you know, Buffalo is one big family, and Griselda, BSF, they family, and they embrace in the city. So as you see, they say Buffalo Kids on the back. And I support it, man. I support the movement. I support Buffalo. And the only way that this thing is going to rock if everybody is going together. So listen, Josh is going to do and what Josh do, and his offensive line is going to protect them. So that's what it is, man.
Love.
Like I said, it's not checkers, it's chess. Feel me?
That's love.
Yep.
Absolutely. Deion, thank you so much for joining us. We wish you the best in this offseason and heading into training camp. And you're welcome to come back on the show anytime.
Daylon Jacoby, I rock
My
with
boy.
Y'all. Y'all keep doing what y'all do. You already know it's your buddy, dog. Ski!
Appreciate you, family.
Later, man.
We had to let Deion go. Wish him the best this offseason heading into the season. But, Benny, I know you pay attention to all sports, not just your Bills. And the Brooklyn Nets, as we stand right now, are title contenders and favorites in the East. Do you see them winning a championship? Who do you have winning it all in the NBA this year?
Man, it's going hard to beat those guys in seven games. They got a healthy team. I see they just got Blake over there, you know what I'm saying? And he's gonna be balling. But you know, Unk, I'm going with Unk. It's the Lakers to lose to me, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? I gotta go with Big Unk. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to King and the whole Lakers. But man, the Brooklyn Nets is scary. They are scary. I gotta admit that. They scary.
They are scary. And Saturday night, it was a revelation and celebration of hip hop.
Yes, sir.
What do you think about the versus battle between the legends, Ghostface and Raekwon?
Yo, that's so crazy. Yo, that I got asked to be there. by Ray, and I couldn't because I was out west shooting a video. But the whole time I'm working, you know, I'm watching it, I'm paying attention, and that was just a dope moment. And man, and those two are my mentors, so it was dope that hip-hop got to have that. You know, that was all of ours, you know what I'm saying? We all, that was something we all wanted to see, have our woo moment. We got our woo moment, man, early in 2021, man, and I loved it.
We certainly did. And you're having your moment right now. You just released The Plugs I Met Too. And yes, it was recognized by the gentleman that you just recognized earlier. LeBron James tweeted about it. What does it feel like to have one of the most influential personalities on the planet support your music the way LeBron does?
Man, it's dope. It's dope. You know what I'm saying? It's like he said he get excited when he hear the music. Like, I wonder if he ever played my music and like dropped a triple double or something, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm thinking now, you know what I mean? So it's dope, and that's just inspiring to see. And he inspired us to be great, so it's good that I could, you know what I mean, just put out something there that guys like him mess with. So shout out LeBron.
Benny, you and I both know Griselda, Black Soprano Family is about the culture and about the bars first. So always. What is it like to be embraced by mainstream America for basically staying in character to what you guys have always been since day one?
Man, it's dope. It just shows me and other people that you just gotta be you, and people gonna accept it or not, and they're gonna accept it for what it is. And you know, the world loves real hip hop, you know what I'm saying? And hip hop is a thing that's near and dear to our heart. And yes, it escalated to what it is today, but the pure essence of it is still alive, and people love that, man, and they support it, and they just like, they like you, they want to hear them bars, they want to hear them stories, and that's big. Mm-hmm. So all the radio music is dope, but don't ever forget hip-hop, man, it's still alive and breathing, you know what I mean? And Griselda, we here.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.